Hello, welcome again. We are solving IDJEE physics. The topic is magnetic effect of current and magnetism. Question number 17 from year 2019 is: two coils P and Q are separated by some distance. When a current of 3 ampere flows through coil B, a magnetic flux of 10 to minus 3 Weber passes through Q. No current is passed through Q when no current passes through P. A current of 2 ampere passes through Q. The flux through Q is options 6.67 ampere per minus 4 Weber, 2 6.67 ampere per minus 3 Weber, 4 3.67 ampere per minus 4 Weber, 4 3.67 ampere per minus 3 Weber. Okay. When the current passes through Q and the flux generated on P will be directly proportional to the current that is passing through Q. Okay, because no current is passing through P and the distance between them is constant. Okay, so all other quantity will be constant and the flux passing through P will be directly proportional to the current that is passing through Q. Okay, similarly, when the no current passing through Q, then the flux passing through Q is direct proportional to current passing through P. Okay. So now these quantities are proportional. So as distance is same for both, so the constant of proportionality is also is same. Okay. So pi P by pi Q is equal to I Q by I P, or we have pi P as 10 to minus 3 and I Q as 3 and I P as 2. So you can learn pi Q as 6.67 10 to minus 4. Option 1 is the right answer. Next. In an experiment, electrons are accelerated from rest by applying a voltage 500 volt. Calculate the radius of the path if the magnetic field 100 millitesla is then applied. Charge on the electron is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb and mass of electron is 9.1 × 10⁻³⁹ kilogram. Options are 1, 7.5 meter and option 2, 7.5 × 10⁻²⁹ meter and 3, 7.5 × 10⁻⁴ meter. Option 4, 7.5 × 10⁻³ meter. Now the energy imparted is voltage into Q. Because voltage is the potential per unit charge and charge is for Q. So the energy imparted is VL into Q. And voltage is given as 500 and charge on the electron is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. Okay. And now this energy imparted is converted into kinetic energy. Okay. This energy imparted to the electron will be converted to kinetic energy if m is the mass of the electron and v is the velocity of the electron. Then half m square is equal to vl is equal to vl cube and the velocity will be root 2 vl cube by m. Okay. Now when this particle comes into the magnetic field, then it will rotate in a circular path under the influence of centrifugal force and magnetic force. And the magnetic force, when it rotates in a circular path, is given by QVB, where Q is charge, V is velocity, V is magnetic field. And this magnetic force is balanced by centrifugal force, where M is mass, V is velocity, R is radius. So it is MV squared divided by QV, V is equal to R. So V will cancel out, so R will be MV divided by QV. So V is equal to this quantity, okay, 2VL Q by M. So R is your M into root 2VL Q by M or whatever QD. Okay. And this M and M will cancel out or become root for 20 R VL to M VL Q whatever QD. And again this is root Q in the numerator is root 2 and denominator is 2. So it will again become 2 m v l divided by 2 root into 1 by 2. So m is mass of the electrode is 9.1 × 10⁻³, and BL is the 500, and Q 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹, and B is the 10⁻³. So putting these values, we can find out R. So R is what? 3/4 × 10⁻¹⁵. So 10⁻⁴ × 10⁻⁴. Just you have to make equation, because here we can easily make equation, because 500 × 2 will be your 1000. So and this is −19 − −31, and this is again 0.1. Okay, so −13 + 22 will become −11. Okay, so 9.1 by 1.6, you can written as 9 by 16, then 10⁻¹⁰ here. Okay, so root of this 9 by 16 is 0.4, and it is 10⁻¹⁵ or 10⁻¹⁹. So I'm sorry, 10⁻¹⁵ meter. Okay. Next, two wires A and B carrying current I1 and I2 as shown in figure. The separation between them is D. A third wire C carrying a current I is to be kept in parallel to them at a distance x from such that the net force acting on it is zero. The possible value of x is, so these are the two wires I1 and I2, and the third wire at a distance x from this I1, and this wire carries current I, and this is the separation between these two wires. Now the possible value of x is equal to ±I1D/I1 + I2. X is equal to I1/I1 + I2D, and x is equal to I2/I1 + I2D. 3, x is equal to I1/I1 − I2D, and x is equal to I2/I1 + I2D. And 4, x is equal to I2/I1 + I2D, and x is equal to I2D I1 − I2. Okay, so this is the wire AA, this is wire BB, and this is wire CC. This is carrying current C, and this is carrying I1 and I2. Okay, now the magnetic field of in C due to this I1 is given by the Sampere circuit law. So B1 × 2πx, okay, 2πx into is equal to μ2i, and B1 will be μ2i1. Okay. So this is the magnetic field due to this current. B1 will be μ0 I1/2πx. Okay. And the magnetic force is current into L into B. Okay. I into L into B. Okay. Where L is length of wire. So B1 is your this quantity. And the magnetic force will be this. Okay. Put in the value of B1, you can have this. It should be in the okay. Okay. Now similarly in the similarly magnetic field in B due to in C due to B will be now distance is D − x. Same way B2 is your μ0 I 2 πd dx, and this will be again magnetic force due to this will be I b2 l. There should be L, so L will cancel out. Now put to have zero force, these FB1 and FB2 should be equal. Okay, so solving this, I0 2π will cancel out. So G − xI1 = xI2, or DI1 − xY1 = xI2, or X = DI1 / I1 + I2, and